Samuel. I read over there where the Bible talks about Israel repenting, talking to God. Talked to Samuel and they said, "Will you pray for us?" Samuel said, "I'll pray for you." He said, "I'll teach you the good and the right way." He said, "But you need to consider what great things God's done for you." And I began to consider what great things God's done for me. Then I flipped over to Mark chapter 5 and I read about where the man come out of the tomb. And he was cutting himself. The Bible said day and night he would cry out. Nobody could tame him. It said oftentimes they had bound him in fetters and chains. That means more than once. And he kept breaking them loose and he'd go out and he'd cut himself some more. He'd run in the graveyard and he'd cry out and cut himself and nobody wanted to be around him. And then the Bible said the Lord passed by his way. Jesus came to where he was and the Bible said he was, after that he met Jesus, he was clothed and in his right mind. After the Lord saved him, the Bible said he came to him and he said, "I want to go wherever you're going." And Jesus said, "Well, I'm sorry, you can't go with me." But said, "I want to tell you something." He said, "You need to go into the city where you're from." He said, "I want you to tell them what great things God has done." I got up this morning and it laid on my heart that to consider what great things God has done in my life. And then I got over in Mark chapter 5 and the Lord said, "Don't you only consider it. I want you to get up and I want you to tell it. I want you to tell somebody else what great things God has done in your life." And I look back at the life I used to live. I look back at the life and what I had, what I didn't have when I was lost and undone. The life that I lived in sin and the things that I didn't have that other people had and the things I wanted that I didn't have. The peace that I didn't have. The surety that I didn't have. I looked at all that. I looked at my life and I said, "I don't even deserve to be here."
That's right.
I looked at the life of sin I lived and I'm not going to brag about, but I'm telling you, I've done things I'd be ashamed to tell you of. I've been places I'd be ashamed to tell you of. And I looked at that and I looked at now where I am today and I realized, I considered what great things God has done for me in my lifetime. I looked at salvation and I said, "I don't even deserve to be saved. I didn't care about God. Why does God care about me?" Yeah. I didn't want to know who God was. I didn't care if he existed or not. And God came to where I was and said, "I love you. I love you so much I went to Calvary and I died on a cross for you. I laid down my life so you could have abundant life." I began to consider salvation and saying, "You know what? I don't deserve that. Why does somebody that I didn't even care about me?" I began to think about heaven. I looked at what I've always had here, Brother Chad, on earth, and I said, "You mean I get to leave all that what I used to have behind and one day get to walk on a street of gold? I get to live in a place and have a mansion or whatever it is God has prepared for me, and I get to have peace and joy forever for eternity?" I looked at that and I said, "I don't deserve that. I'm considering the great things God's done for me." I looked at, I'm telling you, I thought about it this morning as I got up, and I just really fell to pieces, to be honest with you. I'm glad I was by myself. Other men, the Lord. I began to think about the family that God's blessed me with, my beautiful wife that God's blessed me with, my beautiful children that God's blessed me with. And I began to say and consider what things God has done. I looked and I said, "You know, the way I didn't ever beat my wife, but the way I treated her, mistreated her, before I got saved," and I said, "God, you turn around and bless me with a wonderful, godly, beautiful wife." If you'd asked me before I ever got saved, I would agree with abortion, but yet God has blessed me with young children like I have sitting in this pew. And I begin to consider what great things God's done for me. I said, "God, I don't deserve it, because the way I used to look at life and the way I look at life now is completely different, and it's because of you." I didn't consider it back then, but I considered it now, and I consider what great things God's done for me. And then I looked at my church family and I realized God's blessed me with a church family that loves me and prays for me and stands behind me. And I said, "God, I don't deserve that. I don't deserve the ministry I have. I don't deserve any of this. But God in his mercy and his grace has blessed me abundantly." And I said, "God, I don't deserve it, but I want to thank you for it."
Amen.
I had all that on my heart and all that on my mind this morning as I sit there by myself in that upstairs room, and I begin to pray and think about what all God's doing. And he said, son, not only consider it, you need to go tell them. You need to go tell somebody what God's done, how God took you out of a life of sin. He saved your soul. He gave you peace you've never had. He gave you joy you've never had. He's given you a home in heaven. He's given you salvation. He's given you the comfort of the Holy Ghost. And now you got comfort in all situations. You know that there's a bigger hand that holds you and keeps you. You got all this. You used to not have it, but God's blessed you with it. He said, now go tell them about it. That's what he told that maniac. He said, I don't want you to follow me because I'm going to tell them the same thing you got to tell them. He said, but I want you to go where I'm not. And I want you to tell them all about me and all the great things God has done for you. And the Bible said he went and spread it all throughout Decapolis. How about 7 or 8 different cities, I believe, in that place where he went and told what Jesus had done for him. Have you considered what great things God has done for you? I look back at my life, I'm telling you, I wish I could tell you, but I'm not. I'm ashamed to. Where God brought me from, the valley and the pit of sin I was in, till God came and lifted me out of that horrible pit and set my feet upon a rock, established my goings and put a new song in my heart, and blessed me the way he has. I can tell you all day long, but until you experience it, you ain't going to know what I'm talking about. But if you've experienced it, you ought to be able to rejoice with me, knowing that the God in heaven took time to come to where you was and lift you out of that pit and set your feet upon a rock and save your mortal soul. I'm telling you, save you and give you a home in heaven when you didn't deserve any of that. Amen. What did we deserve, Sister Linda? Any of it? Nothing. I don't deserve to be standing up here. I don't deserve to be behind a pulpit. Man, you know the life I used to live? But if God can save the chief among sinners and use him to preach to somebody else, God can sure save me and use me the same way. And God can do the same thing for you. God can do it for anybody. I'm telling you, if God can do what he's done in my life, he can do it in anybody's life. I know where I used to be, and I look at some of y'all, and I know where you used to be, and now I see where you are now. And ain't you glad that God come by your way one day and saved you out of that horrible life of sin and gave you a new life in Jesus Christ? You need to consider today what great things God has done for you. Look back at, hey, if we could put it up on a big billboard and roll back through the years and show your sin on this billboard and let everybody see it on the big screen, you'd be ashamed and hang your head low and you'd probably crawl out of this church. But I'm telling you, because just like they sung, I am free. I am free from the sorrow of sin. I am free of the sorrow of tomorrow. I'm telling you, I got hope. I got peace. I've got eternal life in heaven. I'll tell you what, you can put all that up there, but then when you splash the blood of Jesus on it, it's all gone. I tell you, I've been cleansed. I've been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, my Savior. Amen. I did consider what great things God done for me, but I wanted to tell somebody what great things God's done for me. And I come to church this morning just to share a little bit with you about what God's done in my life. Because some of you sitting here today and you're thinking, well, that's all well and good. I seen them shout. I seen them holler. I seen them praise the Lord, but I'm not sure it's for me. Yeah, I used to be on the outside looking in too, but now I'm on the inside looking out, and it's a whole lot better on the inside. I'm telling you, I've experienced things in church I never experienced nowhere else. I've experienced peace with God. The Bible said that surpasses all understanding. Do you know why he says that? Because all this I'm telling you seems foreign to some of you. If you're sitting here lost, it all seems foreign. You're sitting, scratch your head, say, I'm not sure what they're talking about. You know what that means? It surpasses all your understanding. Till you say, I will. Till you say, I want to know him. Till you accept him as your Savior. And then that natural man becomes the spiritual man. And then you begin to understand spiritual things. And you begin to realize how much God really loves you. I don't know if this was a sermon or a testimony, but it's what God laid on my heart. He told Israel, when they said, will you pray for us? He said, I'll pray for you and I'll teach you the right way, the good and right way. But you need to consider what great things God's done for you. And there's some of us sitting here right now, you may be thinking, well, I ain't got as much as you got, preacher. I don't have what you have. I can't say all that. I'll tell you what you do have. You got what God's blessed you with, and you are a whole lot better off now than what you'd be if you didn't have God in your life. It ain't about having what I got or me having what somebody else has got. It's about having the Lord on your side, the Lord in your life, and then you got more than enough. I promise you that. You got more than what you need, and you got more than you'd ever have if you didn't have God in your life. You say, but I've been down rough roads. I've had hard times. I don't understand why this is happening. This happened. The Bible said it rains on the just and the unjust alike. Some things are just a part of life. But if I'm going to go through life like everybody else, I want to have the one that gives eternal life. I want to have Jesus on my side, the comfort, the God of all comfort, to help me through this life. And you need Him too, whether you realize it or not. You may be sitting there thinking, well, I'm saved, but I just don't feel like I've got all this. No, you don't have to have all this. And how He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all His righteousness. I'm going to tell you what, and that'll give you peace no matter what you have, what else you have and what you don't have. Amen. I didn't have a whole lot either when I got saved, but when I found out I had Jesus, all that other stuff really didn't matter. You know that? But this is what God convicted me about, and I'm done. This morning I got up and I began to consider all those things. I mean, I thought about my job, Brother Tony. I looked at all the things that I'd done wrong in my life that had I got caught in some of those things, I'd have been disqualified to have the job I have. I couldn't have got a job. And had I got caught at a few other things I've done in years past, and I'm serious, I wouldn't have the home I have. In years past, I'd done things I shouldn't have done. Ain't we all?
We all have.
I got to thinking about my life and considering. Then I looked at where I was and where I am now. And in between, I had to see a lot of mercy and a lot of grace to get me from there to over here. The only thing I could see between there and here was there had to be something in the middle. And I found out it was mercy. I found out it was grace that had to get me from over there to over here. And I realized, I considered what great things God had done. And then He said, son, when's the last time you told somebody? The maniac, he just went straight out and started telling it. And I was ashamed. I said, you know what, Lord? I get up and preach to people and tell them how to live, how not to live. I tell them what the book says and all that. But sometimes I fail to get up and tell them what great things you've done for me. I just assume they already know. I assume they already know what's on that billboard in my past. I assume they already know what God's done and what God's given me here. God said, go tell them. Because there's somebody maybe sitting here today. And your life used to be just like mine. Life of sin. Headed down the wrong path. And if you die in that condition, you'll go to hell. That's where I was headed. Till Jesus passed by my way. It takes the hand of God to move me from where I was to where I am now. Amen. It takes the grace of God to get me from where I am now to where I'm going. But today I had to consider those things. Today I want to tell you about those things. Because you need that same Savior. You need that same mercy in the middle and that same grace to get you from where you are now to where you need to be. Let's all stand. You may be visiting this morning and say, is this what every service is like? No.